What's up, everybody, and welcome to this episode of the Little Big Cast. In this episode, Rachel and Robin discuss their first time.
What an experience.
It was a trip.
I think we were all there.
Yeah.
Leon talks about oiling the sword.
Come on now.
I oiled it.
And we talk about phallic plants of Grow Home. Grow Home, you're drunk. We are the Little Big Cast. Welcome. What's up, everybody? Welcome to the Little Big Cast. I'm Drew Tyler, your host for today. And with me, as always, is Miss Rachel Hernandez.
Hi.
Welcome. How are you?
Great.
Fantastic. You've brought a guest with us.
I have. This is Leon. Not Jeff.
Not Jeff.
This is Leon.
Fantastic. Glad to have you here because you're going to fill us all in on what Jeff would usually talk about, right?
I can do that.
Excellent.
I can do that. What is it? What was that again?
We call you Jeff-tiny.
Jeff.
No, I'm excited. I'm excited to have you here. You joined us for one of our faux shows. So for those of you that saw us on Patreon, Leon was one of our faux show contenders. What do you call it? Attendees.
Yeah,
it was awesome.
Yeah, that's cool.
Also here with Robin, Miss Tahitian Paradise herself. Welcome.
Hi.
We'll get into
you
that.
You can't smell me right now, but we're going to talk about
but
it in just a second.
She smells paradise-y.
It is paradise-y. And I'm Drew Tyler. We are basically just four players trying to figure out that game-life balance. So what have you guys been doing all week? I want to hear the Tahitian Paradise first.
Okay.
Let us know about this.
Okay, so number one, this is my arm, and this is a burn.
Oh.
So I tried to make food. That was my first mistake.
Never
I tried
again.
To make
Cooking.
Food, and I burned my arm on the side of a frying pan. And so I read that if you use vinegar and you put it on the burn, that it will take the heat out of it. And it kind of worked, except I got regular vinegar that you cook with instead of apple cider vinegar, which is the thing that you were supposed to get. So apparently I'm like post-cooking my arm. I don't know.
Yeah, that's acid. I'm pretty sure.
Yeah.
That's pure
I was just
acid.
Like, oh, this is going to get.
It's supposed to burn.
I did something similar when one night I had really, really bad heartburn and I was trying to figure out how to get rid of it. So I went and Googled, like, what are the answers? And the answer was to to swallow, like, a cup of apple cider vinegar.
Yeah.
I didn't have apple cider vinegar. I had normal vinegar.
Oh.
So I drank vinegar and it was like, that didn't work.
Bad
yeah, it was just bad. It was bad decision. Home remedy's gone bad.
So same thing, right?
So I'm alive. It feels okay now because I sat for 20 minutes with ice on it. But I also smelled like vinegar. So I got in the car, and the perfume that Scott got me for the four-year anniversary, because apparently I smell weird in four-year anniversary gifts.
You stink. Here you go.
It's fantastic.
I spent time with you. I want to smell better.
It's just like, here you go, honey. This isn't a suggestion. So I grabbed the perfume like, oh, I can smell this thing when I'm in like an enclosed space, and I didn't want to like gas you guys out with vinegar, so I'm like.
It
apparently,
worked,
like, I have overdone it, so I smell of Tahitian paradise.
I don't know,
and apples and vinegar.
I quite enjoy it, considering our usual mustiness. This is a nice change.
Gamers aren't usually known for their odors.
Yeah, right. Yeah. Excellent. That just sounds like a good week.
No, life's good.
Yeah. Anything else? Gaming? Any? Did you put the controller down, Mr. F.A.? I said
that's a good question.
Cooking requires you to put the controller down before you grab the pan.
Yeah, that's one of the many reasons. Like, hot pockets are life.
Oh,
right.
So. Nice.
No pans required.
No pans. It's like, put that thing in, and they even modified it to be exactly 2 minutes. So it isn't like the 215, the 211.
Express button. Mm-hmm. Boom.
How did they do that?
I didn't know.
Magic. They took meat out so that they could lower the
amount
of time.
That's where all my taxes going to.
Yep.
It's science.
Awesome. Any gaming? Do you play any games this week?
Gaming, it was a little bit of Destiny. It was me and Rachel jumping in for Destiny.
For Jeff-tiny's. The Monday night raid.
Monday night Jeff-tiny.
Shake your head.
I think we were all there. We were all there.
I was invited, but apparently someone took my spot.
What? It's my PS4.
I know, but Jeff personally invited me. I was going to raid with them, and then I got nixed because I was not high enough level.
And you only had one PS4.
It was mine. We have my
that's
PS4.
That's ours then.
We could probably just let them work it out.
We'll sit back and figure it out.
I was just jealous. It looks like you guys had a great time. I was watching the raid. It looked like a lot of fun.
Really fun. Well, we could start there because we all participated in some form.
Yeah.
So Robin and Rachel, Jeff and Glenn, and Mr. Hefe and Ski or Die. Is that right?
Yes.
All got into a big giant raid on Monday night, ran the Vault of Glass. I tuned in and watched.
Was that the first one?
Yeah.
That,
okay. Yeah. So I tuned in to watch. I'll tell you, my outside.
What a douche, right?
What did you say? What did you say? I told you.
She had to use the shard. I'm just.
Well, I can't just, do without.
No, we're supposed to do. Well, okay. We'll talk about the shard in a minute. But just from an outsider, it looked like a very fast and easy raid, considering that most of them are like 4 and 5 hours, especially with as many fresh faces. 2 hours was amazing.
Yeah, I think that 2 hours was amazing. That level of commitment is pretty high on my list.
Like, the 2 hours or the beyond?
This could start into like a 4 hour thing. Nope, I'm out.
So you were not ready to even go.
I was just like, we're going to do this, and we're going to do this now. We're going to do this fast. That's give me the rocket launcher. Let's go.
I want to blow shit up right now.
Exactly.
Okay.
That's my motive. I want to blow things up. I don't care what order this stupid light thing appears in. I want to blow them up.
I hear. Okay.
So I had a level 15 and a level. I have not played Destiny. I played it when it first came out. Not a lot, but enough to get to level 15, and then I haven't really played it.
Yeah.
Since, right? So
in spite of lots of coercion and persuasion.
I know. So
I'm just saying.
Just
because I didn't have.
You like Witcher better. Come on.
It's my turn to talk. I was traumatized from the Halo days of playing online and being a female. So I don't know. I didn't really online gaming so much.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So, right. Yeah. So I didn't really play a whole ton of Destiny, and I have a 15 Warlock, and then I had recently started a level 5 Titan. So in order to do the raid, you have to be a 25.
At least, right?
Yeah. Something. So I had gotten the shard that you get with the Taken King, and it levels you up 25. So I did that literally 30 minutes before we started the raid.
Still really a level 5.
So I was level 5, and then I used the shard 30 minutes before, and I had tried running a Taken King mission with Glenn, but I had to stop for some reason. And so I took a break, and I just jumped right back in the raid. And so when you use the shard, you just get a bunch of stuff. You mm-hmm. upgrade, and then you get your second subclass, and then you get just a few kind of weapons. So I got my second subclass, and I was like,
oh wow,
I'm a new subclass, I'm gonna use it.
I'm gonna touch it.
So I immediately engaged it, and then we started the raid, and everyone was going onto this part, and I started jumping. Everyone's like, Rachel, double jump. And I'm jumping, and I'm like, I can't double jump. And Jeff's like, no, you hit X twice. I'm like,
I don't want to.
And so he goes to my profile, and he's like, you don't have double jump. I'm like,
you ain't got
no.
Yep.
That would be frustrating.
I know. I didn't have grenades. I couldn't double jump, and like I would make these. And then I realized halfway through the raid that I could go back and engage my other subclass that had grenades.
So you had a little something.
Because I was level 5, so you have some stuff unlocked when you're level 5. So I was able to double jump after that. But yeah, I was like a level.
Somebody should
have
just put you in like a little papoose and strapped you to their back.
I know.
Like I wish that would have been possible. Like literally carrying the raid.
Did you say papoose?
Like yeah, the papoose.
I know. It's great. Yeah. I haven't heard that word.
It's like the little baby wearing stuff that you do.
Well, considering that Jeff ran the whole raid with a fox hood on, he probably could have had a papoose and mucklucks, and this would have been a fantastic.
Yeah, Jeff basically.
Today you're the Sherpa.
It was pretty awesome. That was my favorite part of the whole raid, is when I realized, because I watched in and out, and you never really see him because I'm watching through his stream. So when I saw that he was wearing a fox on his noggin, I was like, oh, that's so rad. And then when he decided to Macklemore, I was like, that's so funny.
I loved hearing him quarterback the whole thing.
Right?
In the microphone.
Right?
Like, I would see him on screen, like, scanning.
Sorry, it was a wolf.
Just like,
showing us, telling us.
It was a wolf. Telling, shouting out directions. This is great.
It was good, though. And
I didn't know what hidden left meant.
This is true.
He's shouting hidden left, and I'm supposed to hide in the left? What's happening?
Grenade, rocket launcher, go!
But Alpha Tango.
I gotta say, though, that was one of my favorite parts of the raid, because I love to have a well-oiled team doing all
That's
the right
true.
Things. And with Jeff Huang, you two, and Mr. Hef, I think it was his first raid.
I didn't have to think much.
Well, exactly. Yeah. It's like, all right, I will be this cog in the wheel for this part of the raid. I will do whatever you say. And then it takes me 20 times to figure out how to do it consistently to be successful at it. So that's the frustrating part.
Right.
The one that I hate, I think, is the same part that you hate.
Oh, my hell.
The jumping puzzle.
I rage quit.
Every time.
There wasn't a connection error. I rage quit. I was so pissed.
I wondered. I
blamed it on my triple.
I was just like, she's not coming back, guys.
I looked at
she's
Leon and
back.
I was like, no.
Not jumping.
No, I can't do this.
And in the chat, I was like, everybody hurry and jump this puzzle so that she can come back when it's all
over. I was trying to get Drew to come in. And
you did. She tried to tag
I tried subbing. I was like, Drew,
tapped out.
Take my place.
And I was considering it. I went from the project that I was working on, because I was editing while watching, and so I went from that, and I went and set up.
I'm not ready. Closer
to my power strip, so I could set something go. I was getting there, and then I thought she can do this. She can do this. And then I was listening to the commentary, and I saw that you guys were still making progress. That was at the point where you're like picking those hidden left, get the far right, get the back right. The what do they call those things?
The oracles
that were popping up, right?
So, I was gonna say orbs, but whatever.
Yeah, that's where I was. I was thinking about it, and I thought I'll just pop in real quick. Not that I could help out, but my character was strong enough that I could probably help out just in firepower. Because I'm honestly no good as a player. I have a gun.
Right.
I'll come near. I'm a gun. So then when you rage quick, I was like, oh no.
Oh, it's
over now.
I was so happy when you came back though.
Right. Well, here's the thing about the raid. I enjoyed it. I would do it again. Okay. I liked raiding. I thought it was fun. My only two, I have two concerns about raiding. I need to get stronger. It's like when you go to the gym and you like just pick up the huge weights.
Like you see like all the like the swole people just like, oh yeah, I can pick up this like 70-pound weight with my pinky. And it's like, I'm like 5
right?
pounds.
So that's exactly.
And they're calling out, do a dead squat, and then over there, what do they call those? I don't even know the name. Deadlift or something.
Exactly.
And then you'd be like, oh what? I don't even know what that is.
I want to kill myself after I lift. That's a deadlift. Okay.
Was not ready, and I felt like I took a bunch of protein shakes and I went in thinking I was gonna do good, and it just, that's like the best metaphor I can give you.
I
went in and I steroided up, and I got there and I was like, this steroids did not work. I am
like,
not
this facade
able to
fell
do
away
it.
And you're like, I can't double jump.
I regret not training.
Right? So I was like, they said I needed to be a 25 and I need a lot more than that. I don't know. My light level's like 30. It was just, it could have been a lot smoother. So I need to get stronger. And then the second thing is, I don't think I would do a raid for the first time. Like, one reason why I liked the raid was because Jeff was like, go here, do this, do this. This is where the hole is, blah, blah, blah. But he was like, the first time we did this, we spent 4 hours at trying least. Not to get killed by those.
He's like, you go be because the innovator on this one.
Yeah,
buddy.
Yeah, you gotta have somebody like,
I will be the laggard and I'll be a happy laggard.
Sure, that is exactly, yeah, there's so many of those, because I played the second one too.
Holy
which was,
cow.
What's that? Who's, I don't even remember who that is. Is it Crota? No, I don't even remember.
I think
there's two more
I've
missed
Scrotum.
Already.
Scrotum. Yeah, like,
Jeff
I don't.
Is,
you know, he's gonna be so disappointed.
Jeff is going to hear this and be like, you got it all wrong, guys.
But I'll tell you, the other one, there's other puzzles where you have to have, like, people standing on things, and one of them has to grab a sword and run across a bridge that's disappearing as you run, and then they still are on the other side of this huge chasm, and they've got to stand on things, staying alive, while the other three like take turns taking the sword and running across. And again, whoever tried to figure out on the first run, like who has 8 hours at a time to figure
See,
out,
just like,
what, how do I do this?
I can do just figuring out the puzzles. I think would be. I don't think I have the patience for
nope.
that.
I love
not
puzzle games. But not
but
when
not
people are shooting
ones.
At me, and
it's
not
different.
When people are like trying to kill me. I will solve a puzzle by myself.
It's different.
This was like puzzle with like all kinds
with
of
a gun
permanent
in your
tension.
Head.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Not
seriously.
It was Crota. Oh,
oh man. But like just the Gorgons, just like knowing where to go and just Gorgons. Figuring out like that. Oh, when they look at you, they kill you immediately. Like just,
everyone goes.
Just every little thing, and just like the rocks, and like no, just figuring out how Venus and Mars work. Like oh, we have to hit the lights in order. Like that would piss me off if I.
Right?
I would have never figured out you have to hit the lights in order, because if I just saw them, I would just start shooting them, and no progress would have been made, and
just,
I would have been pissed off,
kept
and I would.
Yeah.
Throw my controller and just that's because that's how I work.
Yeah, that's kind of like those little like things like oh so and so died and there's like the guardian makes their own fate or something like that, like those little text things that pop up at the bottom. I'm just like, I don't know what you mean. What is this? Ritual negation is like freaking what?
I don't know
what you're doing.
Right.
What does this mean?
I'd love to hear that you would raid again.
But ultimately, yeah, in the end I enjoyed it. I thought it was fun. It was a good environment, just knowing everyone and just you know, yeah.
I think that's key.
But it's long. They are long. Like that 2 hours is a short raid.
That was,
I'm not used to talking to people for longer than
2 hours. No, no.
And taking orders for 2 hours.
I'm at work and customers go and leave. And like, I hate a few of my coworkers. But I mean, like, even this podcast is even more than 2 hours. So I mean, like, I'm just.
Yeah, just like constant switch out.
Right. So anything more than that, I just.
I think we're taking our relationship to the next level. I don't really feel comfortable with this at this moment, at this juncture.
I just don't have the patience for that. But ultimately, it was fun, and I don't think I would do a raid without someone else who knew.
I would have to have a very locked and close group if I was ever going to go again. I just got really peeved at all the stupid arbitrary crap. You have to shoot the lights in order. You have to stand on this. You have to be. You have to do the rock puzzles before they have to disappear.
Simon says, "Play video games."
That's exactly. And I'm just like, I just want to blow things up. I don't. And so that part was genuinely frustrating. I loved playing with people. I don't know if I would do Destiny, like, immediately after this and just like, yeah, sign me up for another raid.
Because like, that's what they did, too. Like, Jeff and Glenn did another raid right after ours.
I could not do it. I mean, I've got a life. I've got a kid. I mean, I can't. I can't stop. I mean, that's the big thing
about... But you take another night to go play, like, Borderlands 4 person and go play again, right? Yeah. I mean, that's a little bit less tense?
It's a lot less relegated.
Yeah.
Okay.
So it's, you know, like, go shoot things. All right.
Pick your story and go.
Here's your goofy mission. Let's go.
Yeah, okay. And then I can, like, hide behind something, you know, if child magically wakes up after she's gone down to bed. I'm like, okay, I can hide over here and I'll be fine. No big deal.
There is always a respawn point.
Yeah, but, you know, if you are always doing the, like, the Gorgon thing, and if I had to walk out of the room at that point.
Yep. The whole team would sit and wait for you.
There is nothing that I can do to fix that.
Actually.
You know, games are supposed to be adding to my life instead of trying to detract from it. So that's at least my position on playing online.
Right. One good thing, though, about Taken King is I didn't play much of it, but the Destiny, from when I last played it last year, has improved immensely.
Like, absolutely.
I have the desire to go in and play. Like, there's quests, and there's actually quests now, and before it was just kind of a crappy storyline, but now there's, like, side projects.
Things that are happening.
Yeah, there's, like, side projects and missions and things to accomplish. So
bounties.
Yeah, exactly. Yes. Yeah, and that changed.
I like them better. The bounties before just kind of felt like you bounties. Pull cards out of a hat and be like, I'll go try these.
Right.
And now it feels like almost an assignment. Here's your quest. Go and do this. It does feel better.
It makes more sense, just the whole accessing them and just selecting them and things like that. It makes a lot more sense. So
it's a lot more achievement-centered, which is what a lot of gamers want. It's like I can actively see, you know, like I pull up the little ghost menu and I can see the four things that I can track. And that's that is a huge boon.
So
I'm almost there. I'll play a little bit more and I'll just get this.
And I think it was Hefe who was saying that he never played Destiny. It was his son that played. And he was busy on Witcher. But now once Taken King came out, he was actually, like, he raided with us. Like, he's actually been picking it up. So
yeah, I'm with Hefe on this one.
Very cool.
So Destiny was a fun experience.
I'm glad to hear it. I will join you. Start later, and I will join you. But again, same thing.
Yeah, it's
show
too
up
late.
And it's like, I'm out.
Like, start later, and then I'm like, I can't do this.
What do you mean we're only a third of the way done? Yeah, it's been 4 hours.
I know. I was going to be that person and be like, are we there yet? Are we there? Have we killed the things? Did we do the things?
That's awesome.
Okay, we killed it. Now let's go to the next thing. Oh, my God.
Oh, no, it was fun to watch you guys. I didn't get to play. I played a little Destiny after you guys got off and you were done. I got in, did a little bit of Destiny just because I was itching.
Yeah.
But even then, it was more of me, like, exploring the Taken King. So I was looking at the new quests. I didn't really get out to do much raid, much levels. I was just like, ooh, and I go here and I talk to them. So that's fun. Other than that, I played a lot of Uncharted 2 this week.
Nice.
So
I started it.
The remaster is sexy. It looks so good.
There's so many things in my life right now. I went so long without not having anything to play, and now it's like I have Uncharted, I have Witcher, and I have Destiny right now. And so I'm just like, which one?
You should probably call in sick to work.
I know. I should just give up, quit everything. So I played a little bit of Uncharted 2, and it was too hyped up for me, the intro. Everyone was like, oh, it's the best beginning of the game. It was a cool beginning of the game, but it wasn't as cool as It was just too hype. Too just hype. Like Avatar. Just like James Cameron Avatar.
They used an odd reference.
No, they used papyrus in there. I'm out. It's done.
They did use papyrus.
Used papyrus everywhere.
The happiness, what is it? The secret to happiness is just lowering expectations.
Right.
Even in the midst of hype is kind of hard.
I think that's what happened with Ready Player One, and I think that's what happened. So Uncharted 2, don't get me wrong, it was great. It was a great intro. It's been great. It's been fun so far, because I haven't played Uncharted 2 before.
It didn't blow your mind.
But it did not blow my mind.
I enjoyed it, and it was kind of like, what's going on? Here's what I liked about it, and I wouldn't call it hypey, but I enjoyed this idea of, I don't know where I am or what I'm doing. I'm all of a sudden trying to climb up through a chain.
A vertical train. Was kind of cool.
And so that unique way to start a story, and then all of a sudden I get knocked out and start to have almost like a flashback of like how I got here, and then play a little bit more, flashback to another story. Like this kind of...
Postmodern.
Yeah, it's almost like in medias res, but different.
Yeah.
But it kind of feels like, okay, this is... That to me was storytelling-wise. Yeah. Was a fun way to start.
And storytelling.
I think that...
Video game ADD right now, though. So right? Uncharted. Yeah, Uncharted. And I... Yep.
Any plans to, like, nail one or another?
Witcher. I started Witcher before all of these things. I will beat it. Yeah. Can I tell
you?
Can I complain about Witcher?
Just one thing.
Because he hates it. He hates it, and it's all I've
been doing. She's like, I got to put the right oil on my sword.
You know what? Don't hate me right now. What is it? Can I... one thing about Witcher, though. I am a completionist, if you do not know this about me.
Oh, you're done.
Here's the thing.
Literally.
Like a third of the quests are Gwent related.
Do you think that many? I've done the whole thing without any Gwent.
I hate Gwent.
Oh, because of the completionist.
I despise
that's why.
Gwent.
I hate
Gwent. I marked that part off and I just went, I'm not going to Gwent a
thing. Stupid card game.
Oh!
That's good.
You know, you know what I did last night?
Gwent.
I started...
What did you do?
He was like, hey, is this Gwent? There's Yennefer, Kira.
You think so? The boobies. No, I started playing last night with hopes to just knock out a couple missions. However, I got to a point where there was one exclamation point on the map, and I go to the exclamation point, and it's a Gwent thing. So I'm like, okay, play.
There's nothing exciting about that.
And then, but I want to beat it. And so I played it the first time, and I lost, so I resaved it. No, I played it the first time. I've lost before, but I usually only lose like $5. But this is like, this is a special one. It's like a mission one. So I lost a card or something, and I was like, no, I don't want to lose. I don't want to lose the crappy deck I already have. I earned that so far.
Heck yeah.
So, but there's like, you have to defeat the end players. You have to get a card from the Red Baron. You have to defeat some big city guys. And this one was, so it took my card. So I kept restarting the damn game. Until I beat this guy, and then I beat him once, and I want to save, but out of habit of the past,
you reset again.
So I finally beat him, and I go in to save the game, and then the next thing you know, the reloading screen's up, and I'm like, what did I just do? So I try.
It was just so depressing.
Was there
a
lot of swearing going on in the old department?
No, it was just like this sad coming to terms with it.
Just like
it was great.
You're sick. So I played it. Four more times trying to beat him, and I didn't beat him, and I just went to bed. So I didn't even make any progress.
I can't believe you're putting that much
in
effort into Gwent. Made that at the very beginning. I was like, I played one time. I was like, that's too hard. I don't understand it. I want to go kill things.
This is like the crappiest version of Hearthstone ever.
Yeah. I'm not even completioning.
I'm about
just
to get in
through.
With Triss right now too, but I'm just distracted by Gwent.
See, I swore off Gwent way off. Yeah. I was like, never. I'll never play.
Can we talk about priorities here?
Sorry, I'm obviously playing card game.
Gambling when you should be hooking.
Yeah.
Well, I didn't take advantage of the blonde.
That's right.
I'm just.
Kira, you kind of.
See, like, the redhead's kind of cute.
Oh, she's cute. Yeah. Did you get the alternate outfit? They're extra.
The masks. I'm at the masquerade.
Oh, the masquerade is super fun, too.
I'm at the masquerade.
I wore a mask for so long after that it was just funny to see the cutscene. And you got, like, this giant, like, nose.
You did.
So
you picked the bird, didn't you? Yeah. You would pick the bird.
I picked the bird for. Yeah. It's just kind of fun to see him in those different things.
Right.
That's awesome. Anybody else have a week thing they want to share? Leon, what'd you do this week that was exciting and fun?
I played some Destiny. I'm up to 22.
I have not 22, used not a shard 22. 22.
Yeah.
So I'm pretty excited to get up.
You guys have to share, right?
When I'm not home.
I'm gonna end up getting a PS4.
Because you work all day.
Hey, sales, bundles.
I'm sure they're coming up. Black Friday, it's coming. $350 Yeah. It's easy.
Oh, yeah.
We keep an eye on the sales. We kept an eye on the sales for Drew.
That's true. They did. They got me through. And I've very much enjoyed it. So. Well, that's fantastic. Let's jump into news. We ready?
Yeah.
We got a little bit of light. Little bit of light news this week. Here we are, folks, with news number one. The Twitch app on the PS4 officially launched with full-featured PS4 client. So you tune into any stream, no matter what platform it's coming from. And have all the functioning that you ever wanted.
You can see us on a real TV.
That's right. So the software 3.0 is out. We know that. And the Twitch has now landed. So I probably needed that part of the software OS update to do that. But I'm excited about it. I think it is kind of exciting to have just another outlet for the Twitch.
Right. This is I hate the game Monopoly. And I hate Monopoly in general. So I think this allows, what is it, PS Live? PS...
Yeah, the now.
I think it's how we streamed before this. I think it's good because you can stream through the Twitch app now, right?
Okay,
right.
Yeah.
So I think it's good. I think it'll be competition between the two, so we could be like, who can make streaming better than each other?
I'm for competition.
Yeah,
but there's definitely going to be a significant loser out of this.
Right.
Yes, very much possibly, but I think it'll be good. I hate my brain when it stops working.
It's okay. It happens to the best of us.
Yeah, hold up. This is going to be anticipation. It's coming. I don't even know
where it's
gone. It's gone.
Don't worry. We'll get it.
Yeah, we'll get it back.
It'll happen in like news thing.
There we go. Yeah, then I'll come back to it and be like, oh, that's what I hate. No, you know what? This is it. I hate typing on the keyboard,
like this,
actually like trying to comment on things. So watching Twitch in a full-fledged app, even though it's fully available to do the chat and to join in on everything that's on the Twitch app, I don't have a keyboard attached to my PS4. Maybe that's the answer. Maybe I need a keyboard.
Yeah, I just grab my the Bluetooth keyboard that comes with my Mac.
Nice. Oh,
and then just hook that up. So
that's
just
smart.
Do Bluetooth discovery.
So
for
then
that.
You can still chat and follow. Oh, that's what I need to do.
Under my bed somewhere.
Because I do this way too much.
Surprise!
These are under the bed.
What's been living under your bed?
What? How old is Twitch? Less than 5 years. It's got to be less than 5 years.
Four or five,
right?
Yeah. At least, yeah, 4 or 5.
So it's gone from like. It's come a long way. That's pretty incredible.
Because it was Justin
TV.
Justin.tv was just live streaming, and it was started by a guy who basically just streamed his whole life.
Justin.
My friend worked for him for a long time.
Good time.
And I was this close to taking over his job when he left San Francisco. I was going to go and replace. Ooh. And they decided not to rehire. And it was shortly after, about 4 or 5 months after, that they went, you know what? Twitch is doing so well. Let's roll it all into Twitch. And it became Twitch. So it's fantastic.
Quite the growth.
I love story time with Drew. I love it. It's just like, oh my gosh, so much discovery.
Yeah, right? Okay, let's do news time with Drew. Sony's PlayStation 4 continues a 5-month streak as a best-selling console. Anyone surprised?
No.
I mean, we kind of tout that all the time because we are PlayStation fans.
Yeah.
But every time it streaks.
But genuinely, it's just like, it's the better product out there. The better interface.
And we mentioned this before, I'm interested to see through the holidays with bundles and sales and pipe where the other consoles, I say console, but I think there's two, where they're going to land, what they're going to do.
What's the precedent for this? For one console whooping the other console so
it's always been a really good
so
back
badly,
and forth,
like
I think.
Dreamcast? Are we talking original Xbox?
Yeah.
Maybe. That would make
like
sense.
Like OG Xbox and PS2?
Maybe. That's a good question.
I think that was like the first real... Because PlayStation, PS1 had launched itself first, and then came Microsoft after that. But they had staggered it. But right around the time that PS2 launched was when Xbox was
first,
setting itself out.
Yeah.
So and I think that was when it really set off the competition.
When it started.
When it started. The maelstrom.
But it's swung though, hasn't it? Because Sony just dominated that first cycle, and then Xbox came back with the 360.
I think 360
had a good.
360 was solid.
Yeah.
360 was solid.
I owned one for a short period of time. I did.
Yep.
Just to play Fable.
I love my 360.
Except for the red rings. Everyone.
The R-Rod.
That's one of the reasons that Sony I think is doing so well.
They don't have that same pain.
They have a yellow.
But, But it happens far less often.
And your thing's throwing up.
Yeah.
And the throwing up.
It's still throwing up.
What? Is it come back? Or?
It's still throwing up.
No.
Not as frequent as before, but.
You just the disc.
I'm scared. Yeah. Here's the thing. Yeah. Here's the thing. And I don't want to send it in because then I won't have.
Yeah, what are you going to do? What are you going to do with your life?
Then I won't have PS4.
You have to buy yours. She'll be able to send hers in.
That's
no pressure.
That's the transition. There you go.
No pressure.
Got it.
But I was like, I have to send it. What am I going to do?
Yeah.
You can borrow my PS3.
Something.
I still haven't sold it. I totally promised Peach I was going to sell the PS3 when I got the 4.
But you can't. It's not backwards compatible.
I want to play Ni No Kuni.
Everyone's selling their PS3s right now, though. And I've seen so many selling my PS3 and all my games so I can get a PS4 and play Fallout 4.
Yes, they're all gearing up for Fallout 4. Yep.
I can see that. But you have. Remember when. When Xbox did this launch, they screwed it up so bad.
They butchered it. Why did they bundle?
Well, then the executive jumped over to Zynga, so that's like abandoning the Titanic in favor for the Lusitania. So.
Yep.
Really? You're going to make that reference?
That's pretty good. That's pretty good.
They're all sinking ships. Boom. Done.
Jump. Just stay on the iceberg. You'll be fine. All right, news number 3, and this one's kind of cute.
This one's way exciting. Cute.
Ratchet and Clank official movie trailer launched, what was it, late last week. And so if you watch it, and I've played a couple of Ratchet and Clanks, just kind of fun, silly stories. But to see it in animated, like, movie form, almost Pixar style.
I'm excited.
What are you most excited about? Like, story-wise, you kind of get a sense from the trailer what they're doing.
Mm-hmm.
It's almost like an origin of sorts. Like, you get to meet.
Did Christmas Clank. Just happen right. for you, Leon?
I'm so excited. This is so cool. Wow. I remember the terrible graphics from the PS2.
Yeah.
What are you hoping for?
I don't know what I'm hoping for. Just because, like, I was thinking it was going to be more adult, but it's going to be childish.
Younger, yeah.
As long as they don't do the things they tried to do with the Michael Bay horrible bastardization of Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
Oh, right.
Because it's an adult-looking thing, and it's supposed to be kiddish content. I'm like, I don't know where we're going with this, but I don't feel right watching this. But it's because it's a Michael Bay film.
This one actually looks very just clean and young. It does look really young and it seems simple. And I wonder if, obviously, you got to think about games and movies. So is it part of a ploy? Is like intentionally, like meant to be? And we've talked about games and movies before.
Is it a continuation?
Yeah, that's one of their bigger IPs.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No? I mean, is it like, hey, let's put out a nice movie and make it younger so that kids want to play the Ratchet and Clank games that are coming down the road?
Maybe, or maybe it's like a pregame for a new game coming out.
Yeah.
Maybe they're like gearing up for that. But I think it's just, I don't know. Normally I would be like upset about something like this, but this one kind of like.
They waited long enough.
It works. It works for some, right though?
Like they waited for the nostalgia factor for it. So I think that was a really smart move on their part.
Now let me tell you what, I want a Conker movie now.
Oh, Conker's Bad Fur Day.
That's what this made me think of, is I want a Conker movie for adults. That's what I want. Because when I saw Ratchet and Clank make a movie, that's what I was thinking it was going to be PG-13, like, I don't know. And then I was like, oh no, it's going to be cute. And I'm like, okay.
That's cute.
But what if they did a Conker movie? Rated R.
Mm-hmm.
Rated fur. But we'll see. So
we can dream. Maybe we can make that movie. It'll just be, you know, like a little indie film. What do they call it? A little fan flick?
We could
do that. We could totally do that. We got all we need. I've got an army of movie makers.
Pocket Film Fest.
So divine.
We do.
Pay me money to teach a movie maker. All right, last bit of news is a giant PSN sale. What is it called? The Sale of the Dead. Sale of the Dead, huge discounts, tons of games. Did you guys look at that giant list?
I did earlier,
there's
but now it's
so
not loading.
So many games that are being discounted, from The Devil May Cry to Ender of Fire, How to Survive, Grim Fandango, Alien Isolation.
Anything dark. Basically anything dark.
Yeah, it's all.
Whoa.
Sale of the Dead.
Is Devil May Cry a fun game?
I like
it. Isn't it? I've never played. Is it more like Tekken? Like, isn't it just a fighting?
Shooty?
It's shooty.
It's kind of.
I don't play.
Shooty.
So.
Wander around. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Ebony and Ivory.
Yep.
Not like Ebony and Ivory live together in perfect.
Did you like Devil May Cry?
Oh, I love.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah,
okay.
Me too. I loved it.
Jap really? And stuff. When I was little, I thought Dante was cute.
I named the first computer that I built. I named him Dante.
You named the computer.
I had a vinyl like little sticker thing that I custom made and put it on the side because I was I was 17 and I wanted to.
And built it on a computer, right? Wow.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Do you guys see anything else on here that you that interests you? How long is the sale running for? Anyone know?
We don't know.
We don't know.
Oh my gosh, we
don't know. Grab them while they're there. I can't believe I don't have this answer.
It's okay.
Yeah, just get them while you can. Resident Evil's Hungry's.
Like DMC, Devil May Cry? Yeah, that one's awesome. Combi Christ did the first song, like the intro song for it. And I was like, oh, this is the coolest band ever. And apparently they come through here like once a year.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Like they're coming.
That does sound like up your alley.
Don't judge me. Hey.
I'm just saying, like, you know, you're like...
I know.
It's hard to see because I see this Professor Robin, and it's so hard to be, like, like...
I am so metal. It's,
metal, yeah. It's pretty funny. It's
I like being the ironic metal person. Like, I go and dress in, like, cute, bright clothes, and I'm the one that actually knows how to properly headbang. So... And there is an etiquette to the mosh pit.
Yes.
And, boy, is there.
Oh, but nobody knows that.
These damn kids, they don't know how to properly mosh.
My generation in the middle has the hardcore. So we didn't
the windmill?
Oh, the
hardcore dance. So when I was younger, I was like, throw up the X to protect yourself.
Yeah, no, it's like I will basically be stuck in the whole show like this. So you're like protecting yourself and like, get back. I can't move any more than this because everyone's slammed up against me. But
that sounds like so much fun.
It is.
Now, is it different for guys? Are we like down here for the whole time?
No, because like, is it still the same? There's no knees or anything that's going. So you're just jammed into anything.
I did get kicked in the head once because I had my share of pits, but I did the punk scene for a while. So I had all the shows at the Salt Palace and at the fairgrounds for the punk scene, and I ended up with... I saw his wiener. What was the show's name? Rocket from the Crypt. Rocket from the Crypt. They did this hilarious intro where they did the show. They like, and so and so was on the, you know, on the guitars, and they introduced each other. And then we're all getting ready for the show, and it's like second or third song in. And the guy that was introing the band, he was like, "And back here on the drums, it's RuPaul." And the dude stands up and just drops him, but he's got it tucked, and it was like. And again, like a 17-year-old, I was like, "You can do that!" And so it was just so wild.
ICC.
Yeah. I was like, what? So then that was the same show that I was. I tripped in this circle, you know, because they kind of have this like
the whirlpin
going.
Circle pit.
And I tripped enough that I was down on all fours. And wouldn't you know that somebody with combat boots was like, "Oh, football!" And they just booted my head like while I was down on the ground, and that was it for me. I was like, "I'm too little. I'm fragile." And that's when the words from my mother came ringing back in my ears: "You're a lover, not a fighter." And that was the end of my moshing days.
Story time with Drew.
Yeah.
And that, my friends, is the news. All right, folks, we're gonna roll out of news and right into our indie game of the week. This week we played Grow Home, which was a September game of the month, right?
Yep.
Robin's gonna take it away and tell us all about the things we need to know, and then we'll tell you all we think about it.
And then we'll just get into it.
We'll get into it.
So yes, we chose Grow Home because we're broke and PS Plus is awesome, and it was actually a really good game. So they are from Ubisoft Reflections. Their Metacritic score is a 75. The overall story is, feel the freedom of unbounded climbing as you take control of Bud, the botanical utility droid, a procedurally animated robot on a quest to save his planet. Create your own path through an alien world as you control and ride giant plants on a vertical journey to the stars.
Giant plants, that's the part I remember.
Lots of giant plants and lots of clicking buttons back and forth.
Mm-hmm.
So the basic mechanic is you are Bud, and your home thing is called Mom, M-O-M, something like motherboard, something, something or other. But it was basically like this mother-child relationship, and it would scold you every time that you die, which happened to a lot to me. It's like, really, Bud, you should be more careful.
It would.
Such as what we've got going on the stream at the moment. So we would run around, and I would try to not get sick. And of course, completionist me would pick up every single plant. You'd pick up the plants.
Just because they can't be picked up. You don't get anything fun, do you?
I would always think, like, is there something behind this one? Is there something behind this one?
That's Super Mario Brothers.
Yeah.
It's true. Yeah. All the blocks.
There's got to be a secret in here somewhere. I will pick up all the plants. Yep. Exactly. Yep. And finding the crystals, trying to find the specific caves that you could be able to go into.
There's a cave?
There are caves.
Oh.
So
you didn't find them.
I found one, like, walkthrough area.
Yeah. It was like it wasn't really hidden. It was like, there are caves in here. Yeah, if you keep looking, you could find them too.
If you only tried harder, that's what I feel.
That's not what I'm saying. The game mechanic was actually kind of interesting because I kind of felt like it was like co-op.
Where you have to, the stupid one where you have to like walk the legs and the arms and make the thighs and the legs.
QWOP. QWOP and the OMP. And it's like, do I like move this and like where do I get the arms?
And that's how
it was the trigger buttons, right? The L2, R2 or the R1.
L1s, I think.
Yeah, it was the R1, L1. And so I'm sitting there with the controller and going click, 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 click. And all I'm thinking is like, if I'm ever going to stream this, everyone is going to hear.
Yep.
It's like, okay, I got it. And I climbed for so long, and then I would miss getting onto a branch, and then I would fall, and like, please hang on to something.
You'd be like trying to
grab something. Yeah.
And so you can grab little dandelions and have them as like little umbrellas. Uh-huh. And so the little ticker on your backpack that you're wearing. The longer that you stayed in the air, the faster those little ticker things would fall.
Almost like a little countdown to lose.
Yeah. It's like, oh, the end is near. And so you'd get on these little telerouters, and those would be like your save points.
See, that's my...
And
how'd you do?
I couldn't figure out how to make the telerouter work at first.
At first?
I'm just like, do I just touch it? Okay, I touched it. I mean, what do I do now? Like, it lit up. I guess it just lit up no matter what. But then I realized that you had to grab the side and pull it down in order for it to launch.
To do stuff.
And when you find one up, I only found one other one besides that first one that it's, like, dealing. And then it took me a little while to figure out you got to pull down all three sides to get it to launch.
Yeah.
You walk around and get it. But.
Yeah, that was my main regret. What was y'all's take on it?
I felt like the mechanics were fun at first. Like the first time, it was like you walk like this, and you can grab onto things, and you pull them out, and you do this. And I thought that is really okay. That's okay. That's fun. And then as you jump down and you grab your first little umbrella and you get down to the star plant that you're trying to grow, I was really tired of this. And I was like, and then it showed you like your little map because when you go to the teleporter, it's like you have this much to go, and you're down
so
here.
Depressing.
And the first I made it to one teleporter up, one level, one like extra layer up, and that I was done. I was already done doing this, and I thought, wait a minute. So the whole game is me like, it feels like I'm squeezing an udder. I don't know what this is, but that's what it's like. The whole game is me climbing like this, and so then you have these little flowers that you grab onto with both hands, and they just shoot out, just wah.
It's like this.
Like this.
This action.
And then you're supposed to aim it. And
at those green,
you hold two other triggers while you're holding or something. There it goes. Yeah, it's not phallic at all.
Totally not phallic.
So then it powers up and it grows the rest of the plant, and you get like four more of those. First time I did it, I got four of them. I grew the whole thing, but I started aiming because it was like you can aim this. So I climbed onto a plant and I started to try and direct it and aim it with my trigger.
I couldn't
and I missed
see anything.
Him. I missed them all the time. And then Glenn told me, Wiggs was like, hey, you just hold on and it pointed already. It'll just hit the thing it's supposed to hit. So I did play one other time after that, and it was a little easier to go on and just hold on and not try to drive it, but actually just be like, let your instinct drive that phallus. Bam, you hit it every time. So I did. I got really tired of the clicking. I'm saying. Not that way. It was just that way.
I didn't get far.
You didn't get far?
I didn't get far at all. I played for a little bit, but I think I really like linear games. I like having a destination and a quest and stuff like that. So I played for a little bit, and it was just the clicking and the climbing, and I wasn't sure where to go or where I was supposed to grow. So I did not get very far.
Yeah.
But I tried.
I think I went back twice, and my take was I didn't. I guess I didn't, there wasn't a drive. Like, it wasn't, the story was very simple and kind of fun, but I think at my puzzly kind of gaming guy, I was just like, this isn't enough for me. So I never really felt like I wanted to get back to it. In fact, I think the second time I started playing, you know, it was like, all right, kids come in, let's have dinner, dinner's ready, let's eat. And there was no desire. I was just like, okay, I'm done here.
Right.
And I didn't get after dinner and be like, all right, let's see what I can do to get the kids out of the house so I can finish playing, which I do with other, you know, Witcher and other things. But this was just like, I'm done with, I don't want to do this anymore.
It's like I have no drive to, to really do it.
Right. I really...
But it's
it's fun. It's unique.
What I've read is talking about what else, because what else has Ubisoft done? They've done Valiant Hearts and Child of Light, and this is very different from both of those games.
But that was a different studio.
This is a reflection studio. I mean, it's part of the
incubator studio. Ubi Art is what is who did Valiant Hearts and Child of Light, and then this one I think was another
Reflections. Ubisoft Reflections.
Another incubator studio.
Mm, well, there you
Or at least they had the funding from Ubisoft.
Right, to make it.
So, yeah.
But I'd have to say that it just... I don't know if maybe I was in a different place in my life. It might have felt better. Or if I had a... I don't know. I felt... If I was younger...
There was high.
Maybe... You know what it is? Maybe if you treated it like a Smash Time game, sort of. Like, you know, like a Bejeweled or something where you're like, you know what? Like I'm going to grow another level. Yeah. Right. I'm just going to do it. Rather than... It's not when you're going to jump in and campaign through for 3 hours. It's no raid, my friends.
I have other things to do right now.
Right. So if we were to give it a Metacritic score, Metacritic gave it 75. What would you?
Oh, gosh. I'd give it like a 70. It's a good game. It has good mechanics. It's just it doesn't give me the drive. So there's nothing truly broken about it. So I can't give it like, oh, this is a 60. I'm like, no, this is okay. You get a C.
Yeah. Let's see. I think I would probably be in that same 69-70 range.
Right.
Like, I think I'd be down there where it's just kind of like, thanks for coming up to class and doing what you're supposed to do. You did nothing for me.
Yeah. Right. It's like,
I'm not impressed. Adequate. It's like mediocre. So.
Right.
What did you put it?
Personally, I probably would. I'm that person that says, 60. Yes. But my word is not, don't take. Like, that's just my personal...
You didn't rage quit go home, did you?
Don't say not play it.
Yeah. Don't... It's not... It just...
If you picked it up, it was a free game.
Yeah, it was free. And that's another thing, too, is that this broke... What was it? I wrote this down somewhere. Is now the fastest downloaded game on PlayStation.
Well, really? The big
thing... because, yeah.
Yes. You...
Don't do it.
Do it. I know the answer, too. Because...
Robinstock.
Okay, fine. Nose goes.
We have something to say. All three of us want to go ahead.
I know. But it's just like, who has the talking stick? But the main reason is because this was the first one that people could vote on.
Yeah, this was a big deal.
So this and so it had such a groundswell of support. Like, there were people on Twitter, like, yelling back and forth, like, you need to vote for Grow Home because it's made by really fantastic developers and it's actually a really interesting game. And the other idiots are going to vote for zombies and crap like that. And the other one that's out.
That's true.
So
that's true.
And so I thought it was really interesting. Like, it's the fastest downloaded because everyone was just like, you know you want this.
Right, so I thought that was cool as well. Just because it's
It came out.
It was the guinea pig. It was like, let's see how this whole voting thing works.
I can't believe I missed the vote for October's game. Is there a vote up right now? I didn't see it either. Because I really felt like I enjoyed the voting process.
Part of it.
Yeah.
I think that because
it was an anti-zombie vote. That's why I loved it. You know, I hate the zombies. So I was like, that's not zombies. I'll do that one.
True, hate zombies.
I hate zombies. You didn't know this?
I wasn't aware. I gotta go on the backlog and check out
the other episodes. The basic premise for me is zombies are just not scary. I can outrun them. I don't really have brains, so they're not gonna chase me. No, like I don't get it. Yeah. I'll tell you what does get me though. Demons. You put demons or something scary or supernatural or like evil in a game, and that's where I'm just like, oh, I can't handle. And I won't play those. I'll just take my puzzles and my Smash Time games, and that is all I can handle.
Yeah. That's it.
Well, let's wrap this up. I think we all chimed in on that. So let's wrap up with some quick new releases and then send our flavors home.
For October 20th, 2015. So this week, what is it? It's 21st.
Yes,
so it's all these came out yesterday. If you're watching live and if you're listening later, these came out the week of October 20th. Yes, so we have, for the PlayStation 4, we have Adventure Time. Finn and Jake Investigations. I love Adventure Time. We also have the Arcade Archives game is Cosmo Police Galavan.
Which I never heard of the first time it came out.
Me either. Assassin's Creed Syndicate.
Oh. Yeah? Are you worried about this being similar to the others?
I think they learned their lesson.
Okay.
I think they learned their lesson big time.
I saw someone,
Pleasant, a female protagonist. What?
Evie
Fry, woo!
This is the one that takes place in London, like 1800s, right?
Yeah, apparently play Frogger in this, like with like passing ships. And you can like get to the other side of the dock
hilarious. Okay. We need to play this one night. We just need to all come in here and play.
Yeah,
that's on the PlayStation 4. I know. Someone bought an Xbox One. They bought Liberation, and they're like, "Look what I got!" I'm like, "Oh,
you missed it."
You'll find out soon. So we have Code Realize, Guardian of Rebirth, and that is on the PS Vita for PlayStation 4. Again, we have Forced.
Is this been out? It's
a local multiplayer.
Co-op action RPG. Maybe we should all play that.
Yes,
I would go for that.
We also have Guitar Hero Live for the PlayStation 4 and the PlayStation 3.
Which is taking over my freaking Twitter feed right now. Oh my gosh, promoted tweets. I do not care about Lenny Kravitz nor James Franco.
I have seen a lot of James Franco, yes. Hasbro Family Fun Pack for PlayStation 4. So you get to play Monopoly.
What? Other titles? Does it say what the others? I want to
Four classic titles. So probably Monopoly.
Like Game of Life. Maybe
in Racco. Make your family hate you even faster.
I've been playing Monopoly Junior with my kids, and we've actually had some pretty good times.
Okay, Monopoly Junior, I can get.
You can give me that.
What is Monopoly Junior?
You have like, there's only four things, that, you know, four properties on each side, and it's all with like $1, $2, or $3, and they're like $1 million, M dollars.
Uh-huh.
But it's just really simple. Like, you have to buy the property the first time you land on it, so that everybody, as they go around the board, once you start to populate the board really quick, and then when you land on somebody's property, it's just double. So there's really no houses, there's no hotels.
It's fast moving. It first isn't person like to go this out, 3-hour ordeal.
Yeah, first person to go out ends the game.
Oh, that's nice.
And then it's like, okay, count your money. You don't even count properties. You don't count like any of that like liquidate assets. You just go, you went out, I have $20, you have 10, you have 5, I win. Yeah, that's a game.
That should be regular Monopoly.
All I can think of is the Dane Cook stand-up bit about Monopoly. It's like you start playing Monopoly and you just like table flip. Grandma is a cheating.
I have to look that up. That sounds.
It is fantastic.
That is about the Dane I'm enjoying it. So I may actually pick up the Hasbro set here.
Woo! Just Dance 2016, PlayStation 4, PlayStation 3. I'm impressed. They're still doing it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No camera, no problem, and no additional hardware
Oregon
is required. And then we have the Oregon Trail.
No.
But Oregon Trail.
Oregon Trail.
My heart.
Like,
which is zombies, retro Oregon. Zombies. Yeah.
And that's a PlayStation 4, PlayStation Vita cross buy. Looks like it's in 8-bit.
Oh,
mm-hmm. Yeah.
Overlord, Fellowship of Evil for PlayStation 4.
Picture looks pretty, but I don't think that's gameplay.
Pretty sure it's not.
We also have Pocket God versus Desert Ashes.
Now, I enjoy Pocket God. I did. Is that a Vita? Oh, and a PS4. Mm-hmm. I would play it on a PS4. I enjoy Pocket God a lot.
We have Primal Carnage. Extinction for the PlayStation 4, and it looks like you shoot dinosaurs.
Dino Punk?
For the random JRPG of the week, Tales of Vesteria for PlayStation 4, PlayStation 3.
Vesteria.
I have to say, is that it? Okay. Yep, I had students that were making Let's Plays just because that's something I wanted to make for content for the TV station.
Because they needed credit.
One of them made this fantastic Let's Play where her and her two friends played it wasn't a JRPG, it was more like a Sims of a dating game. And so to hear three college kids commenting on a dating game where like a lady would show up and like near to nothing and be like, oh, I must have forgotten my clothing, my bathrobe. Just to hear them commenting on that made my entire week. I was just like, that is some funny stuff. And not because it would be funny for anybody else, but as an old man watching three college kids play a really silly Sim, I was just like, amused. Very amused.
Entertained me.
Yeah, that's exactly what it was. There are our new releases. Hopefully you picked some of those up. A lot of those looked very good.
Yeah.
It looked very interesting.
Oh, there goes my money.
Yep. That's the problem. It's the money.
Nice.
So thanks to everybody that has joined us in chat. This has been our show of episode 73.
Yes.
We're gonna wrap it up here because I think we went a full hour, and we always have so much fun. We can never stop, and the fun never does stop. If you follow us on our Twitters at LittleBigKast or on Facebook, we have a Facebook page. You can like and join us there. You can follow each and individual one of us on the Twitters or the Twitches. You can follow me at Night20.
And Robin Hazlett because I'm really creative.
You can't miss us.
I'm Pirate Rachel with 3 instead of an E.
And I'm Aileon.
Alien. Still, find those in the show notes if you want to find us and follow us. And as always, you can support us on Patreon. We have a patreon.com/littlebigcast where we you can pledge some extra support each week. It's kind of like a crowdfunded per month. And that allows us to buy new mics and to pay for our hosting for our podcasts and all those other things. But if you don't have it, still listen.
We
spend
our
money on video games, and we need money for hosting.
Yes. This is probably what it comes down to. A lot of this equipment here is also borrowed, and so we are always looking to just kind of support. So there's extra content. We have extra content on our Patreon, and there's lots of other fun things that you can see and do. You get some of the snippets from before and after the show and our lives, and we invite you to join us in special things.
Yay. We do things for money, and we don't feel bad about it.
That's the bottom line. Thanks, everybody. This has been episode 73.
Bye.